Welcome back to Big Deal. And looks like that consolidation in the e-commerce space is really picking pace. When the country's largest e-tailer goes shopping, it does so in style. Flipkart has just bought fashion online portal Jabong in a $70 million cash deal through its subsidiary Myntra. Now, this move only goes on to consolidate the homegrown unicorn's position in the e-commerce space. And here's why the deal makes sense. Jabong has the largest portfolio of foreign brand on offer, and it also has a strong presence in the national capital region as well. Now, brand loyalty may be one of the reasons why Myntra and Jabong will continue to operate as the two separate entities of Flipkart. What's more, this deal won't really be a drag on Myntra, which was acquired by Flipkart 2 years back, now that the parent company is funding the entire deal from its own capital pool. And the management team at Jabong will stay put, at least for now, except at the top, where Myntra CEO Anant Narayanan will take over to oversee the transition. And Myntra could really learn from the high net promoter score maintained by Jabong. And last but not the least, this acquisition also helps Myntra spread its wings in the offline space, opening its first store in Bengaluru, which helps it increase its omni-channel push as well. CNBC TV 18 caught up with the man of the moment, Anant Narayanan himself, to find out why this acquisition makes sense for Myntra.
Jabong, both as a brand, a company, their focus on international brands, their focus on women, their strength in NCR, all made it quite attractive for us. And as you then thought about Myntra plus Jabong, and you basically said, how do we actually continue to really shape the fashion and lifestyle market, we thought it would be a terrific asset, right? And I actually, while it's an acquisition, I also think of it genuinely almost as a partnership to say, how do we actually continue to grow and scale the business? Also, from a Flipkart group perspective, it made a ton of sense because Flipkart Softlines plus Myntra plus Jabong actually can really now actually operate on all parts of the market and continue to actually shape the market. So we're very excited about it, both as a group and as Myntra.
Will Jabong and Myntra continue to operate separately? Is there a timeline on merging both of those entities? What is going to be the brand positioning for both of these? Since you all both function, now of course Jabong is part of Myntra, but in a very similar space.
Yeah. So look, no intention actually to merge the companies, no intention to actually merge the brands. I think Jabong as a brand has its strengths, Myntra as a brand has its strength. So 95% of our attention is going to be on growth, and we will of course leverage capabilities of each other to actually make it better, right? But that's actually the goal of what we want to try and do. It's growth.
Will there be any redundancies, any job cuts that people should be wary of?
Even if a customer is buying things on Myntra and buying things on Jabong, they're buying two different things because the selection is different. And fashion is an emotional category, right? So you actually buy different things. So I don't see that overlap as a particular issue. I see it as growing the pie and continuing the customer base and increasing the customer base.
All right, consolidation in the e-commerce space, and we will talk about that in the later shows in Big Deal as well. That needs a lot of focus. But at this moment, I'm afraid it's time to wrap this particular edition of Big Deal. But remember that focus is shifting on the deal street. There's so much activity, and we'll keep you up to speed right here on Big Deal every week. So keep it with CNBC TV 18, and thanks so much for tuning in.